The reason that I love to sing, act, and dance is because of my mom. She has always been a big influence to me because she's a drama teacher. I've always been interested in all of her musicals and that she's done and all of the plays that she has taught in her classes. I love my mom, and that is why I am still doing singing, acting, and dancing today.
I like to act, sing, and dance because of my music teacher, Miss Peebles. She introduced me to show tunes and acting and all this music, and ever since she taught me that, I've been really just in love with music and theater. And then camps started coming to my mind, and then I started joining camps and acting.
I like singing and acting because I love being able to get into a character and really express how they felt in the moment.
Hi, my name is Joe Pearlstein. I am in 8th grade and I have been involved in Warts for 2 years. I was involved with Madagascar and now I'm involved with Behind the Mask.
I'm Bobby Goggin and I'm an 8th grader. I've been involved for most of the productions from when I was a 6th grader, starting with Chairs and The Music Man and another straight play that I forgot the name of and Madagascar.
So I was just reminded that my very first production was actually, my very first little part of the drama program was I was in painting the sets for Willy Wonka, and I just remembered that. But what I think my first production was I did Chairs, which was one of the Wart Shorts things. And it was so fun, and it really helped me build my confidence in myself and in acting, because that was one of the first times I had ever done something on stage. And I can't say that I would like be doing what I'm doing now if it wasn't for me being a part of that.
My first production here at Walker was Madagascar Junior. I was 13 years old. Now I'm 14, almost 15.
The first production I was in, this is actually, there's a little drama club, and when I was in second or third grade, we had this little play we did. It was very messy, like no one understood what to do, no one could figure it out, but it was a ton of fun.
Oh my God, guys, did you hear the news? Ella's engaged!
Perfect match, cause you've both got such great tasting clothes.
Of course he will propose!
Dear Elle, honey, mazel tov. Future's taken off, bring the ring back and show it to me.
4 carats, a princess cut. Are you psyched or what? I just wish I could be there to see. When he gets down on one knee.
Oh my God, you guys. Looks like Elle's gonna win the prize. Was a perfect couple, this one qualifies. Oh my God, you guys!
Oh my God, this is happening. Our own homecoming queen and king.
Final should be trying on a huge engagement ring for size. Oh my God, you guys!
Oh my God!
Shut up, Elle. Shut up, Warner. Shut up, engaged. Oh my God!
Okay, everybody sign. Good, now fall in line and we'll start the engagement parade.
Light candles and single file. Don't forget to smile. Lose the gum, Kate, you look like the maid.
Sorry!
Now prepare to serenade. 2, 3, 4.
Daughter of Delta Nu,
soon to be fiancé. Now that a man chose you, your life begins today. Still in your hour of need, let it be understood, no man can supersede our sacred bond of sisterhood. Oh my God, you guys!
Guys, she's not here. Bruiser, where's Elle?
Yep!
She doesn't have an engagement outfit.
She's totally freaking out?
Yeah.
She's trapped in the Old Valley Mill? Oh, sorry, the Old Valley Mall.
Oh my God, you guys. Fashion prices to supervise.
No one should be left alone to dress and to accessorize. Oh my God, you guys.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
But this dress needs to seal the deal, make a grown man kneel. But it can't come right out and say bride. Can't look like I'm desperate or like I'm waiting for it. I gotta leave Warner his pride, so bride is more implied. Oh my God, you guys. All this week I've had butterflies. Every time he looks at me, it's totally proposalized. Oh my God, you guys! So help me dress for my fairy tale. Can't wear something I bought on sale.
Love is like forever, this is no time to economize.
Oh my God, you guys!
Oh, blondes make commissions so easy. Excuse me, have you seen this? It just came in, it's perfect for a blonde.
Right, with a half-loop stitch on China silk?
Uh-huh.
But the thing is, you can't use a half-loop stitch on China silk. It'll pucker. And you didn't just guess then, because I saw in the last May's Vogue.
Oh my God, you guys.
I'm not about to buy last year's dress at this year's price.
Elle saw right through the circle's lies.
Perfect for blonde, but I'm not that blonde. I may be in love, but I'm not stupid, lady. I've got eyes.
Oh my God, Elle Wood, sorry, my mistake. Courtney, take your break. Just ignore her, she hasn't been well. Try this, latest from the lawn. Go on, try it on. I take care of my best clientele. It's a gift from me to Elle. Oh my God, you guys. This one's perfect, and it's just my size. See, dreams really do come true, you never have to compromise. Oh my God.
Oh my God, oh my God, you guys. Let's go home before someone cries.
If there ever was a perfect couple, this one qualifies.
Cause we love you guys.
No, I love you guys.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
You guys.
Oh my God.
One of my favorite memories of Warts was learning the choreography from Madagascar Junior and working with Ms. Arjona, who runs the high school productions, and getting like a taste of how she works for, so I could prepare for next year.
I just remember this is when we were first figuring out like all the costumes at the beginning of rehearsal one day for Madagascar. Riley Light, they got him these ginormous like high top, not heels, but platform shoes that were a good 8 inches because he was playing Marty the giraffe. So he was trying to figure out how to dance around and everything, and so he took a big fall, like almost the slow-mo dramatic falling backwards into it, but he was fine after, but I just thought that was really funny.
So in sixth grade, I was in The Music Man Junior, and I was Amaryllis in the show, and it was just like a featured role. It had a couple of scenes, and they felt so important to me, and they're still so important to me, and it's one of the best experiences I've ever had in my experience of doing theater.
but what you've done to my motorbike, I may never get it started now.
If it weren't for me, madam, you might have gone headfirst over the handlebars.
Well, excuse me, but I happen to have a sticky carburetor and I'm simply here for a part.
By the sound of it, you're in need of an adjustment to your butterfly valve.
I'm fairly certain I need a new choke pull string.
Oh, don't worry. Our daddy will fix it. He's an inventor.
Allow me, madam...
Truly.
Absolutely.
No, truly, that's my name.
Truly. What a pretty name.
Thank you.
Craticus Potts.
Excuse me, but shouldn't you be in school? You're not sick, are you?
Oh no, we're fine.
Good. Where's your mother?
Mommy's over in the churchyard.
Well, she ought to be looking after you. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. But just why aren't you children in school?
It's a holiday.
And what holiday might that be?
Eastmas!
Eastmas?
I'm so glad you came. It's much more fun with two grown-ups.
Truly scrumptious.
You know, even if we didn't know your name, we could have guessed it.
Oh?
You had to be have called something lovely.
Like Yum Yum!
Or Angel Cake!
Or Toot Sweets!
Toot Sweets? Oh no!
Toot Sweets sound like what they are. So do lollies in a lollipop jar. Gingerbread men have a gingerbread sound we found. Sugar plums, cinnamon and lemon tart. Tell you what they are right from the start. And your name does the same for you. By coincidence, truly scrumptious. You're truly, truly scrumptious. Scrumptious as a cherry peach parfait. When you're near us, it's so delicious. Honest, truly, you're the answer to our wishes. Truly scrumptious, though we may seem presumptuous.
In the world, I'd probably be someone who's on Broadway, and that's a really hard question for me to answer because I admire so many people. But I'd probably want to be Sutton Foster, who's done a lot of Broadway productions and who has become a name in the theater. And it would be a dream come true if I could have what she has.
I think probably Adam Sandler, because he's my favorite actor, because he's like basically done what I want to do. He was an actor. He also did a lot of comedy and stand-up like that, which I think is personally really cool. And he doesn't forget where he comes from or anything like that. He appreciates all the people that he was brought up with.
What you staring at? Haven't you ever seen a gent?
No, never. Sorry, I didn't.
That's all right. Hungry?
Yes, I am. I've come a long way. I've been walking for 7 days.
Been run away from the beak, have you?
The what?
Don't say you don't know what the beak is, Flashmate.
It's a bird's mouth, isn't it?
My eyes! How green can you get? For your information, a beak's a magistrate. So, who are you running from then? Your old man?
No, I'm an orphan. I've come to London to make my fortune.
Oh, you have you? Got any lodgings? Money?
Not a farthing. Wow.
I suppose you want some place to sleep tonight, eh?
Do you know of anywhere?
As it so happens, I know a respectable gentleman. He'll give you lodgings for nothing.
Really? He must be a very kind old gentleman.
Oh yes, he's very kind. And I'm a particular favourite of his. Well, if you're coming along, I better know who you are.
My name is Oliver Twist.
Mine's Jack Dawkins, better known among me more intimate friends as the Artful Dodger.
Pleasure to meet you. You sure the old gentleman won't mind?
Mind? Consider yourself at home. Consider yourself at home. Consider yourself part of the family. We've taken to you so strong. It's clear we're going to get along. Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares? Whatever we got, we share.
If it's your chance to be, we should see some harder days. Empty larder days, why grouse?
Always a chance we'll meet somebody or foot the bill when the drinks are on the house.
Consider yourself our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can state, consider yourself one of us.
Consider yourself
at home.
Consider yourself
one of the family.
We've taken to you
so strong.
It's clear we're
going to get along.
Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture. There isn't a lot to spare.
Who cares? Whatever we got, we share.
Nobody choice will be la-di-da or uppity. There's a cup of tea for all.
Only it's wise to be handy with the rolling pin when the landlord comes to call.
Consider yourself our mates.
We don't want to have no fuss.
For after some consideration, we can state, consider yourself one of us.
In sixth grade, I was doing Legally Blonde Junior little shorts from that when the eighth graders were directing their plays. And I was chosen to be Elle in Legally Blonde. And it was
one of the first times I'd ever had a really big solo part in one of the shows. And I was so nervous, and I was so nervous I wouldn't get it right that I thought I didn't want to do it. But in reality, I just cared about it so much that I really wanted to get it right in the moment. And I could remember being in a classroom the few minutes before the actual production started and feeling like I had put in the work and done enough to get it right. And I remember just feeling fulfilled. And that's something that I want to continue feeling as I do this, which is what motivates me to put in hard work to what I do. And it kind of feels like a full circle kind of moment because I'm being L in the Oh My God, You Guys number. And I feel fulfilled from, at this point, I feel fulfilled from the work that I've put in, so.
One time that I struggled was backstage when I was doing Elf Junior with another theater company. And we had 30 seconds before we had to go on stage. And I forgot my scarf and everybody else had theirs. So I ran quickly backstage all the way into the dressing room, which was way further back behind the stage. And I grabbed my scarf and ran all the way back just in time for my cue. It was pretty stressful.
Girls, you get away from my shop. Why don't you go improve yourselves or something?
Improve ourselves? Mister, when you're in Skid Row, there ain't no such thing.
Alarm goes up at 7 in the startup town. You put in your 8 hours for the powers that have always been.
Sing it, sister.
Till it's 5 p.m. You go downtown where the folks are broke. You go downtown where your life's a joke. You go downtown where you buy a toke. And you go home to Skid Row. Home to Skid Row.
Yes, you go downtown where the cabs don't stop. Downtown, where the food is slop. Downtown, where the hoppets flop in the snow. Down on Skid Row. Uptown, you cater to a million jerks. Uptown, your messengers and mailroom clerks. Eating all your lunches at the hot dog carts. The bosses take your money and they break your hearts. Uptown, you cater to a million whores. You disinfect Toronto on their bathroom floors. Your morning tribulations, afternoon's a curse.
And 5 o'clock is even worse.
That's when you go downtown,
where the guys are drips.
Downtown, where they rip your slips.
Downtown,
where relationships are no go.
Down on Skid Row.
Down on Skid Row.
All my life I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for, and he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep the floor, kiddo. I started life as an orphan, a child of the street, here on Skid Row. He took me in, gave me shelter, a bed, crust of bread, and a job. Treats me like dirt, calls me a slob, which I am.
Downtown.
That's your home address, you live.
Downtown.
When your life's a mess, you live.
Downtown.
Where depression's just status quo.
Down on Skid Row.
Someone show me a way to get out of here. 'Cause I constantly pray I'll get out of here. Please won't somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot or I'll rot here.
Downtown,
show me how and I will.
No,
I'll get out of here.
Downtown,
I'll start climbing uphill and get out of here.
Downtown,
someone tell me I still could get out of here. Someone tell Lady Luck that I'm stuck here.
Downtown,
gee, I would be swell to get out of here.
Downtown,
bid the gutter farewell and get out of here.
Downtown,
I'd move heaven and hell to get out of Skid. I do not know what to get out of Skid.
Downtown,
a hell of a lot to get out of Skid.
Downtown,
people tell me there's not a way out of Skid.
Downtown,
but believe me, I gotta get out of Skid Row.
This was one of the straight plays. This was during the rehearsal, like our final one, doing the whole entire play. And we couldn't find this one guy. We didn't, no idea where he was. We were checking everywhere, and then we went in the dressing room to try and find him. We turned the corner to see where he was, and he was like hiding on top of a shelf, just like peeking over, just looking over everybody.
So in the opening cues of Madagascar, everyone was scrambling around backstage trying to get to their places. In the opening, the song was beginning, the first notes, and I had to come up on stage. And it was pitch black darkness in the wings, and I actually got hit in the face by someone. I'll never know who they are, but I had to get hit in the face, and then I had to come on stage and do a whole thing after just right across my face. So that's probably the funniest thing that has happened to me backstage of a show.
Well, during Madagascar and during the rehearsal process, Mr. Smoot, who was one of the directors, every time I was in the hallway, he would shake his hips at me and say, boom, boom, which was a line that I had in Madagascar. And no matter where I was, it was in the beginning of the at the start of the hallway or at the end of the hallway, he would always do that, and nobody else knew what he was doing except me.
Hi, Mr. Smoot, it's me, Logan. I just wanted to say I'm sad that you're leaving, but I just want to say I'm grateful for the amazing things you've taught me. You've been a wonderful teacher, drama teacher. You're hilarious, you're amazing. You're incredible. You're one of the best drama teachers I've had. I'll be sad once you leave, but I just want to let you know that you've done an amazing job teaching us, and that you have, and that I'll never forget you. Thank you, and I will really miss you. Bye.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. Thank you so much for being my drama teacher this year. I really appreciate your hard work. I hope you have a great rest of your school year.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. It's Lucy. I just wanted to thank you for everything that you have done for me. From even just knowing you 1 year, I've already learned so much through drama practices and passing through you in the halls. I will always remember the advice you had given me in Skid Row practice through all my singing and acting. Thank you so much again, and I will always remember you as being one of my favorite drama teachers. Bye!
Hi, Mr. Smoot, it's Riley. I just want to say thank you for everything you've done for me this year. I had so much fun with you in Warts, filming Halloween and Independence Day, and I hope you have a lot of fun in your new chapter of your life. Bye!
Hi, Mr. Smoot. I heard you're retiring, and I just want to thank you for all the hard work, dedication, and time you put into the students here at Walker. You will be missed very much, and I hope you enjoy your retirement.
Thank you, Mr. Smoot, for teaching at Walker for so long and putting up with kids who are very unruly.
Mr. Smoot gave me my first chance to try doing sound for school productions, and was probably the main person who started me on the track of what I'm planning on studying in college, technical theater and audio design. He's such a sweet guy. He's so energetic, and he's so just full of just life. We're going to miss him. He brought kind of a fire to the middle school drama department, and I know that we're all going to miss him once he leaves. Mr. Smoot, thank you so much for kind of giving me a chance and starting me out on technical theater, and I'm so glad to have done so many shows with you and worked with you.
Hey, Mr. Smoot, I'm sad to hear you're leaving, but I hope you have a good retirement. I just wanted to say thank you for all that you've done. I had you for English in 7th grade. It was always one of my favorite English classes. I also had you for Warts from 6th to 8th grade, and it's what inspired me to do theater. It's why I continued to do it in high school. I just wanted to say thank you for all you've done.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. While it is sad to see you go, I'm happy for you, and I wish you well in the future. I really honestly have you to thank for my love of drama and my continuation of it through high school, honestly, all the way, well, into senior year from 6th grade. I remember the first musical, Annie, in 6th grade year. I came to Walker in 5th grade, really only had a few friends, and I was so excited to go and participate in it, and I got there, and you foster such a exciting, loving, endorsing community, and it was intoxicating, honestly, to be a part of the musical, and then I was a part of the play, and it kind of snowballed, and I just really have you to thank for my love of acting, and I'm really sad to see you go, because future kids are gonna miss out on that, but I'm just really thankful for the love of theater and of English you fostered in me and in all the other kids who have had you for English and drama, and I wish you well in your retirement, Mr. Smoot. Have fun in it, but thank you.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. It's sad to see that you're leaving, but I just want to say thank you for all that you taught me in 7th grade English and also in 7th grade and 8th grade drama class. I remember playing Hitchhiker, and I had a really good time playing those games, and I wish you the best.
Hey, Mr. Smoot, I just want to say thank you for all you've done for the Walker community and to help make my first middle school year and first musical in middle school such a great experience. Because it was my first year, I didn't really know anyone or how the program worked, so I just want to thank you so, so much for making it such a great experience for me for my first year. We love you.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. Thank you so much for helping instill my passion in theater. I enjoyed it so much ever since 6th grade, and I enjoy it even more now, and I just wanted to thank you so much for giving me that opportunity. Thank you.
Mr. Smoot, had I not performed in your plays, I cannot say if I would have learned how much I love theater. Every time you've directed a play, you have brought the cast and myself from nervousness and just overall being scared to go up on stage and do something to being proud and being confident in what we've created together. And just your expertise and spontaneity in your craft in general is inspiring, and it inspires me every day to just work harder and to be better and to continue performing because it's what I enjoy doing. We're really gonna miss you, Mr. Smoot. Thank you so much from all of the people who you've helped, who just, all the theater kids who've been inspired and been brought to continue doing what you love and what we love. Just thank you.
Hi, Mr. Smoot. I just want to thank you so much for everything you've done. I became a better student in English because of you and your class. I learned to have confidence in my writing and got constructive feedback and criticism to become a better writer. I also got to engage in scholarly discussions with my peers, where I felt that I could be challenged through our discussion and assignments that we had. I hope you have a great time in retirement. Please come back to Walker and visit us soon. Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Smoot, just wanted to hop on here to give you a big thank you, and thank you for everything you have done at Walker and for this community. I started with you in sixth grade, and when I auditioned for the musical, I wasn't too sure about how I felt about it and what I wanted to do, but you helped me so much through that whole process and really helped me form my love for theater through your instruction and guidance, and also one of the best English teachers. I had so much fun with you in seventh grade, and I know that that class was probably unforgettable. But yeah, we just wanted to say thank you, and we are going to miss you a lot.
Hey, Mr. Smoot, if you don't remember us, I'm Michaela.
Hi, I'm Natalie.
And we just wanted to come on here and say thank you so much for all that you have done back in middle school with the drama program.
Yeah, I really enjoyed my drama class with you in seventh grade. It made me feel really welcome to the new school and just taught me a lot. Same with doing eighth grade black box performance with you. It was a fantastic experience, and you just taught me so much and you made me a better actor.
And even though I wasn't a part of the drama program that much besides Music Man, back in middle school you made every single musical and play so enjoyable and so welcoming, and we just wanted to thank you so much for that, and congrats on your retirement.
Yeah, congrats.
Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
But how can I go about being a father when I had no father to show me?
Just calm the child. Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother, you'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Do not let that grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one is alone. Hold him to the light now. Let him see the glow. Things will be all right now. Tell him what you know.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lay a small village at the end of the wood.
For the things you say,
and in this village,
children will listen,
lived a young maiden. A carefree young lad and a childless baker with his wife.
Children may not obey, but children will listen. Children will look to you for which way to turn, to learn what to be. Before you say, listen to me. Children will listen.
Careful the wish you make. Wishes are children. Careful the path you take. Wishes come true. Not free. Children, sometimes
I'm definitely excited to do all the high school musicals and plays, which will help me become a better actor and performer in general. And also, it would be something great to put on my resume to help me get into a good arts college, because this is something I definitely want to do. Plus, I'll be working with great people who love theater as much as I do, and it's great working with people who have such a passion for their work.
I really think the set designs of all the upper school plays are cool, and even just like if I get to be able to be in the ensemble of it, I think I would love that. It would be a cool experience.
Although I will really miss the middle school program, that's where I got started with all this, I cannot wait for the huge amount of people, different experiences, different ages. I've heard that in the high school, it's much more combined with all the grades. So I just can't wait for everyone to be together and everyone to be putting in the work and doing something and collaborating and creating something that we can just show to the rest of the school and people outside from the school.
If I had any advice for someone who really loves theater or music, I would say keep going, keep practicing, keep up with the path that you are on if you really have a passion for it and want to do something like this in the future. Sometimes things may be hard, but it all will be worth it in the end.
I really think you should try it out, because when I tried out for the first like real play in sixth grade, Chairs, I was extremely nervous. Like, I didn't know what it was going to be. I didn't know if I really like it, but I just tried it, and I ended up having a ton of fun, and it was a really cool experience.
This is definitely advice for people who are doing theater, but I would say it's also advice for, honestly, anyone in general. You shouldn't not try something just because you're not good at it to begin with. A lot of people choose not to do things that they're genuinely interested in because they're not good at it immediately. And I think that that's just not a healthy way to think. And I thought like that when I was in sixth grade. I looked up at the eighth grade and I was like, I can never compete with that. I'm never going to be as good as those people. I'm not as good as the people around me. And I thought that I wouldn't be able to do it just because I wasn't good at it immediately.
But the thing is, if you're willing to work hard for something and put in the work for something you're really passionate about, you will improve, and more will come out of hard work than anything else.